Alright folks, today we are grilling a huge chimney ribeye. So stay tuned. It's time to grill. Where are the times where we haven't sizzle zones, max zones and infrared cooking zones? How have we cooked our steak? I'll show you today. This is Bambuco charcoal from my favorite online charcoal dealer, makebriquette.de. I will put a link into the video description so you can check it out. And this is the starting chimney, and we just put the charcoal into the starting chimney. You might have seen my video about bacon turtles and the discussion about on making revival videos on old classic techniques. This is one of the videos riding the revival wave. All you have to do now is light up your starters, place on the starting chimney, and then let the chimney heat up completely. That bamboo charcoal gets really, really hot. It might take a little bit longer for starting, but it gets really, really hot and it's really long lasting. So this is one of my favorite charcoal. In the meantime, we can now prepare the ribeye. This is a dry aged entrecot from my favorite online butchery, oberpfalzbeef.de. I'll put a link in the video description as well. And this is so thick, it's massive. It's 1.3 kilo and it smells awesome. Now take a sharp knife and cut into the fat cap. Otherwise, the ribeye wouldn't stay in that shape. And now take your favorite salt. I'm using salt I bought last year in southern France. That's where I normally do my summer vacation, and due to Corona I wasn't able to visit it this year. So I'm so lucky I bought so many of these salt bottles from there. I guess it might last until next year and I'm hopefully being able to drive there again. Now take a grill grate, place it on the starting chimney, heat it up a little bit, and then put on the steak. And I love that song. And I could watch that footage all the time. Be careful, you have to stay there and watch the steak. It's really hot and it gets a nice crust. You can see the fat is starting to caramelize really, really soon. It's very quick. Make sure to have not too many flames, otherwise your steak could burn. Here's a close up. Looks good enough to eat already, I guess. Yeah. So who needs a sizzle zone? Okay, it's time to do. Anyway, I would appreciate you leaving me a comment if you are totally in that technique and you know that. And or if this is completely new to you. This is really important for me because I know if it's completely new to you, I guess I could take more video ideas from that time and make revival videos. So please leave me a comment. Yeah, the upper side is perfect, I guess. And that's it. Now take it off. Take off the grill grate. You will now need one of those charcoal baskets. Fill up one of those baskets with charcoal. Maybe a little bit less, but I will show you later. Put on the grill grates, place your meat, close the lid, open the vents, and let that sit there until it has the internal temperature that you like. And I'm a little bit disappointed right now. I'll show you why. From outside, it's perfect. That's the best crust I have on a steak for a long time. Really. Really, really, really. But all in all, the cooking process after that was too quick. I prefer my steak pink inside from coast to coast. And now we have those small gray parts on the upper part and on the left part of the steak. And this is, it's really good and it's juicy. You can see the juices running out and it's full of flavor, of course. And that's the best crust, everything. But I'm still a little bit disappointed. Yeah. Okay. Anyway, We sold this again, and of course I'm gonna give this a shot right now. Please make sure to hit that like button, leave me a comment, make sure to subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. Also make sure to visit my fan pages, Instagram, Patreon, Facebook, TikTok. Anyway, thanks for watching, I'm out, see you next time.